Have you guys ever heard of prostate massage? Well, I've been getting this question a lot. What, is it safe to do prostatic massage, and what exactly is it? I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and today I'm going to answer exactly those questions. If you're new here, I am a urologist and pelvic surgeon, and I talk about all sorts of urology on this channel. I talk about sexual health, bladder health, and much, much more. So if you're new here, make sure you subscribe, hit that notification bell so you don't miss my videos each and every week. Before we get into prostate massage, it's important that you know exactly what the prostate is. So the prostate is a walnut-shaped gland that sits underneath the bladder around the P-tube or the urethra. So how do you access the prostate? Well, it's actually through the anus and into the rectum. So that tissue overlying the prostate is essentially the rectum, and that tissue is very delicate, and so you want to be very gentle when you're performing any sort of prosthetic massage. Typically, when we do any sort of prosthetic exam, we have gloves to cover our fingers to make sure no bacteria from our hands get into the rectum, and we use a very well lubricated finger. You want to make sure that if you, for some reason, are doing prosthetic massage, that you make sure your nails are not very long, that your hands are very, very clean, and you're using lubricant that is specific for anal intercourse or anal play. The reason being is the pH of the anus is actually different from the pH of the vagina, where generally lubricants are used. And so you want to make sure you get specifically a lubricant that's made designed for the anus, because its pH will match that of the anus and not cause any abnormalities in the balance or the normal flora of that area. And if you want to learn more about lubricants, you can check out my video on lubricants to learn more about that. And the prostate, unfortunately, can create a number of different problems for men over the course of their lifetime. Prostatitis is one of these things that men can often experience. And we can find it anywhere between 11 and 16% of men in the world, and we see about 2 million visits a year in the United States for this problem. Prostate massage was actually used very, very commonly for the treatment of prostatitis, or inflammation of the prostate, as a medical therapy up until the 20th century. And what exactly is prostatitis? This video is not going to go over all of prostatitis because it's a pretty complex disease process, and if you're interested in learning more about it, please comment below and I will make a video about it. Chronic prostatitis is usually a symptom complex, or it has basically a number of symptoms that are correlated with pain in the pelvic region or the perineum, which is the area between the scrotum and the anus. Can also have some component of issues with ejaculation and issues with urination. So the reason people used prostate massage for prostatitis is a number of different reasons. Number one, they thought that doing the prostate massage would actually allow expression of the prostatic secretions. Number two, they thought that it relaxed the pelvic floor. I've talked a lot about high tone pelvic floor throughout a lot of my videos, but essentially what we think is that a lot of times people have elevated tone or high stress in their pelvic floor that can cause a lot of pain. So doing the massage actually relaxes some of those muscles. Number three, it was thought that if there was any sort of biofilm created by bacteria, which is essentially a layer that bacteria can form that's really difficult for antibiotics to penetrate, can be disrupted by the massage itself. And lastly, it would improve circulation in the prostate, and all of these things together would allow antibiotics to penetrate the prostate better. To start off, I'm going to explain the most recent data on the use of prostatic massage for chronic prostatitis. In a study, they took 81 men with chronic prostatitis. So they divided the group into men who got antibiotics plus prostatic massage versus those who got antibiotics alone. And they wanted to see the difference. Does prostatic massage actually make a difference? So in this study, they were given specific instructions on how to massage their prostate. They were told to massage their prostate for 4 weeks, 3 times a week. They were told to massage the prostate for 6 times on each side, or the lateral edges of the prostate, and then a few massages in the middle. So bottom line from this study, what did they find? So what they found was that prostate massage didn't add any additional benefit to antibiotics alone in this small cohort of patients. So largely, prosthetic massage as a treatment for prostatitis has largely been abandoned. I looked at another systematic review of all the studies on prostatic massage, and they don't really show a huge benefit of prostatic massage on prostatitis. However, we don't really know the ideal duration. How often should people be doing prostatic massage, and how long should they be doing it for? And so all of this stuff leads a lot of questions that are unanswered. However, despite using it for medical purposes, many people find prostatic massage to be very pleasurable for sexual purposes. And that's not surprising. There's a lot of nerve endings on the prostate that can cause it to be pleasurable for some people to undergo prostatic massage. However, if you're going to do prostatic massage for sexual purposes, there's a couple things to keep in mind. Number one, you want to make sure you have consent from your partner to do it. If you are initiating the prostatic massage or asking for it, you want to make sure the other partner feels completely comfortable with moving forward with that. After you obtain consent, you want to make sure that you're using a clean gloved hand or a clean hand with lots of lubrication. The rectum itself makes no lubrication, so if you don't use any lubrication, you are at risk of injuring the rectum and creating bleeding. And so it's really important to use lots of lubrication. And you never want to do a prostatic massage on someone who has either acute bacterial prostatitis, meaning they're having a lot of pain, fevers, chills, pain with urination. They might have prostatitis, so you don't want to do it in those patients because you could spread the infection from the prostate to the bloodstream and make them very, very sick. Also, you want to be very gentle with the prostatic massage. Aggressive prostatic massage has been correlated with a number of complications, including rectal bleeding, flaring up of hemorrhoids. And in men who have prostate cancer, they have seen some potential spread or metastasis of the prostate, which may be correlated with prostatic massage. Well, hopefully that answers your question. Can prostatic massage help you? Well, maybe if you're having some chronic pain, or it might help you have some more pleasure in the bedroom, but make sure to do it gently, do it carefully, and be clean. So hope you enjoyed that. As always, remember to take care of yourself because you're worth it.